In this video, I'm going to show you how to make the most of the template library in Pear Deck, modify them for your class needs, and also demo from both the student end and the teacher end what this all looks like. If you haven't used Pear Deck before, I'm using the add-on that's in Google Slides, and I open that Pear Deck add-on. What I'm gonna start with is this template library, and this template library, honestly, has made me a better teacher. It helped me ask better questions to my students. It reminded me check in with my students at the beginning of the lesson, during the lesson, at the end of the lesson, and we're gonna talk about some of those slide types today. And also, they have other slide types like social emotional learning specific questions and critical thinking. We're gonna go through a variety of these types today to apply some of the ideas we just talked about. So let's start with beginning of lesson. And so I love some of these. As you come in and get settled, follow these instructions. So let's start with that. All of these slides are designed by the Pear Deck team. The illustrations are already there. They're nicely designed, and you can customize them based on what you need. So while it suggests find your seat, take out your classroom device, and in Pear Deck answer this question, I might change it up and I might say, one, check in with a person sitting near you, then take out your classroom device and class materials, and then in Pear Deck answer, what did you learn about your classmate? Maybe we could celebrate some things as a class and so forth. So again, just giving you ideas and then getting creative with it from day to day and editing these so that they fit the class needs and also they really get at that checking in with each student and having students check in with one another. Let's look at some others. Draw two things you already know about today's topic. I think that's a great question type. Think of a question your classmates might have. What do you wonder about today's topic? How was the homework assignment? Thumbs up, thumbs down, draggable question type. This could also be a temperature check to see how students are doing today. So again, all of these are editable. Great inspiration here. Then say we go a couple slides into class and now we're ready to do a during class. So just a quick check, take a moment, summarize what you've just learned. You could have them drag their dot to see how they're feeling. I really like this one and I use it often and I change up the language here. So not just keep going, I understand I'm a little confused and stop, I need help. You can edit all of these to whatever feels best for what you're doing. And I try and incorporate something about the question or something I want to get more information about my students from that day. So I do try and again, change up the text that happens there. So it's not redundant from day to day, but also I like to develop some patterns for my students. So I do like to do a beginning, middle, and end of class. But again, just shuffling the question types that I'm asking. There's a nice one of start a mind map. So just have students kind of summarize what they have learned so far in the middle of class, just taking a pause, let them synthesize the knowledge they've learned so far. I also really like this one that says students, it's time to stop blank and start blank. And that's like a goal setting thing. And they can put step one, step two, and step three. So this is meant to be a transition template, but sometimes what I do is I actually change the type of question it is because I want them to type on this slide. So here's how I do that. Let me show you. Because this one is not meant to be any question type. You can see it just says students follow the instructions on this slide. But what you can actually do is go back again, and you can make this a drawing type slide so that students can type anywhere on the slide. First of all, delete this bottom bar because we don't need it, and then make it a drawing type slide so that students are going to be able to type text directly on the slide and also draw with their mouse. And so then they can fill the slide out. And then since I don't want step one to kind of be in the middle of their typing, I just delete those. If I have some specific directions on what I want them to stop and start and what I specifically want them to lay out the steps for, or sometimes just leave that blank and let them fill it out as we go about it. And I can show you when I go to present this, what this is going to look like and how students can fill it in. Let me go back to the template library, go back to during lesson, and just show you that they even have a stretch break in here And do you feel comfortable sharing your thoughts out loud right now? Multiple choice type question. So again, just some little check-ins that you can do during class. And then end of class, some great connections, like connect to your own life. There's so much power in students connecting what they learned to prior knowledge, as we already talked about. So this is a great question type to ask. In 1 minute, write the most important thing. And I love that one. Like I was saying, I love to hear what students think was most important from what we said versus what I thought I had gotten across as most important. Do those things align? Just a temperature check. How are we feeling now? Pretend your friend was absent from class today. Write out what they had missed so you allow students to summarize it in their own words, some other reflections also. And then let me just show you the social emotional learning templates. So we have a moment of silence. What's filling your bucket today and what's draining it? I love that. That's another drawing slide type. And then let me show you the stress check, which is a draggable. And I just want to gather a couple different slide types so that when I do the demo of what it looks like for students, you'll be able to see different slide types. Can you imagine someone having a different perspective than you on this topic? That's really nice. An active listening type question. What differed between your opinions? So, again, checking in with students, allowing them to see how they agree and disagree with others in their class. Did you find this lesson interesting and challenging? Again, they have other ones here, critical thinking. They have subject area specific templates, but I think that's enough for the demo portion. And let me go ahead and start the lesson. And I'm going to put this in student paced mode so that you can see what it would look like for students to just kind of scroll through some of these slides. And so this is my teacher view where I would be able to see all students logged in and how they're answering. You can see that's why I'm waiting for responses here. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you what it looks like on the student end. So I'm going to log in as a student. I'm going to just copy this link and open another tab to pretend I'm a student right now. And you can see that when you log in, Pear Deck automatically asks, how are you feeling? So it does this climate check. If you've never seen that before, by the way, it is something that you can enable. Let me show you before we move on how to enable that. So if I go to my teacher login and I go to my settings under my account and then settings, you want to turn on the classroom climate. And here's also, if you don't have takeaways enabled, how you can turn on the takeaways. All right, now that we've done that, let me show you what this looks like for a student. So here's the demo portion. So here was one where students just answer the question on the side because this was a text type slide. So I learned XYZ. And then let me go back as a teacher. And you can see in real time that's coming in, and I'm able to see what that student is saying. This is the teacher dashboard where there's names attached. There's also another projector view where you would be able to display all the answers anonymously. And this view is, of course, what I always project on the main board. This has no names attached. The teacher dashboard has the names attached. Okay, let's go back as a student. And here's a draggable question type. So I can just go ahead and drag my dot. Then the next one, this was the drawing type. And so you could go ahead and just draw. You can see it's quite thick, but I can change the size of my pen and also the color of my pen. And now I can draw. I can also type some text. Just like that, I can change the color of my text, move it around. I can also change the size of my text, bigger and smaller. And I can also type in any of these boxes here. Type it, move it, resize it. There we go. So that's how easy it is for students to fill it out. And then from the teacher end, I can see all their work coming in real time. So that's wonderful. I can just scroll through it all, or I can look in grid layout so that I could see more answers at once. And then I wanted to show the stress check. So this is another draggable type, but it's a draggable line. So you can see how all students in the classroom are feeling. And this overlaid layout would actually stack up all the answers on one so you could see where the whole class is in terms of how they're feeling instead of individually one by one that you would have to scroll through. So that overlaid layout is a beautiful way to get a quick temperature check. So hopefully you now have a better understanding of how I really rely on the Pear Deck sidebar, not just the questions that I can add, the interactivity that I can add to any of the slides that I've made, but also really trying to use the template library that Pear Deck has so thoughtfully built to make my lessons even better for my students.